हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द कोड फॉर ट्रैवलिंग सेल्सपर्सन प्रॉब्लम बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ डायनेमिक प्रोग्रामिंग। एज वी आर फैमिलियर विद द कंसेप्ट, लेट मी शो यू द एडजेसेंसी मैट्रिक्स। द ट्रैवलिंग सेल्सपर्सन विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम जीरो। इट हैज टू विजिट ऑल द सिटीज एंड इट हैज टू कम बैक to its origin, that is city number zero. This is the code where this explanation has been given. If you are observing, there is a two-dimensional global array, that is A, 10 by 10. This is the array. This is nothing but array A. Then there is a visited array, which is of size 10. This is the visited array, which we have marked. And there is a global variable, that is cost is equal to zero, that we have noted over here. If you are observing, there are some functions like get is there, like min cost is there, or least is there, and put is there. So there are four functions and there is a main. At the beginning, main will go inside this particular get function. So control will jump from this main to get. So get is located over here. This is the scope of get function. Let me highlight this. So there are a couple of variables, index variables I and j. So it is asking to enter number of cities, and we will enter n as number of cities. So here n will be 4, and it will ask to enter the cost matrix. This particular nested for loop will let us enter cost matrix. If you are observing here, A of I and J are entered. And whenever we are entering a particular row, that means this for loop will execute for this particular line, this particular scanf. And for every row, visited entry will be marked at zero. That means for I is equal to zero, visited zero will become one. So I will run from zero to three. So visited zero, one, two, three will be zero at the beginning. So if you are observing, here I have executed the code, and here it is asking to enter number of cities, and it is asking to enter the cost matrix. And if you are observing, it is asking to enter elements of row 1, row 2, row 3, and row 4. So that is this code. So enter the elements of a particular row. Enter the elements of a particular row. And for every row, we are making visited of I is equal to 0. So here, when we will enter this particular matrix, so visited of 0 will become 0. Similarly, visited of 1 also will become 0. Visited of 2 will become 0. And visited of 3 also will become 0. So this will be the output of this particular for loop. After that, it will run this particular for loop and it will display this particular array. That means it will just print this array. If you are going to the output here, I will highlight the output. After entering four rows, those four rows are identified as a cost list. This particular cost list I have taken over here. Right? Now from here, control will again jump inside main. Now inside main, main will print the path is. So let us go to the output, and here it will display the path is. From here, control will jump to min cost of 0. So min cost is a function which is located over here. What is the input argument for min cost? That is this 0. So here, min cost will accept city is equal to 0. So I will mark here the variable city is equal to 0. We'll mark here city is equal to 0. Okay, now we will jump inside this min cost function. Here it will mark visited of city is equal to 1. That means visited of 0 will become 1. So let us go over here. Visited of 0 will be changed to 1. From here, it will print this particular city. So what is this city here? This is 0. So if you are observing in the output, it is printing this 0. Again, code will come over here and it will now call list of city. So list is a new function which will take input argument as city. What is the current value of city? Current value of city is equal to 0. Now it will execute list 0. So control will come over here and this c will become 0 now. Now let us take this value c is equal to 0. We'll copy this and we will mark c is equal to 0. Here nc is 999. Nc is a variable which has been kept as 999. We will mark this nc as 999. Let us write this nc is equal to 999. That is the infinite value. Again, minimum is also initialized to 999 and kmin is a new variable. Okay, now this for loop will get executed. If you are observing this for loop, inside this for loop there is a if control statement and there is one more if, and accordingly the values are getting changed, right? Now what is going to happen? For I assign 0, I is less than n, this is the valid condition. If a of c I, what is the current value of c? Current value of c is 0. And what is the current value of I? I is also 0. So if a of 0, 0 is not equal to 0, is it valid? A of 0, 0 is not equal to 0. It is not valid. Because here a of 0, 0 is 0. In that case, this if will not execute. Right? If this if is not getting executed, then this if also will not execute. So control will come out of this one and now I will become 1. Okay, so I'll mark here the value of I over here. I was initially 0, now I has been changed to 1. Now for I is equal to 1, again we will come over here. If a of ci, that means a of 0, 1. What is a of 0, 1? That is 10. So this is not equal to 0. This is correct. And visited of I, what is the current value of I? 1. Visited of 1 is exactly equal to 0. Let us check. Visited of 1 is 0. This is also valid. That means both the conditions of this if are valid. Then it will jump inside and it will check this condition. If a of ci is less than min, that means a of 0, 1. Because c is 0, I is 1. A of 0, 1. Okay. So here a of ci is less than min. What is c here? C is 0. So a of 0, 1 is less than min. What is the value of min? The value of min is here identified as 999 if you are observing. Min is 999. So 10 is less than 999. This is valid. So it will jump over here. In that case, we are going to do what? Min is equal to a of I, 0. What is the current value of I? I is 1. A of 1, 0 plus a of 0, 1. I hope you are getting. So a of 0, 1, because a of I is what? A of 1. So a of 1, 0. A of 1, 0 is what? So this is 5, right? So we will mark that value over here. And let us calculate this value. This calculate is what? Min. So we are going to update min here. Min is initially 999. Now we are going to update this min by this value a of I 0, that means a of 1 0 plus a of ci. C is what? 0. I is 1. So a of 1 0 and a of 0 1. A of 1 0 and a of 0 1. So 10 plus 5 is what? That is 15, right? So I is 1 0. A of 1 0 is this one. 5. And a of ci, c is what? C is 0. 0, 1. 0, 1 is 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. So min will be updated to the value that is 15. So this will be updated to the value 15. And k min will become a of c comma I. So what is a of c comma I? C is 0 and I is 1. So A of 0, 1 is 10. So this will become C min. Let us copy this and let us paste it here. And we will calculate now C min. C min will become now 10. Okay. Now, this is not C min, this is K min. By mistake, I wrote here C min. This will become K min. So K min will become 10. And NC will become I. What is the current value of NC here? NC is 999, right? So NC will become I. What is the value of I here? That is 1. So NC will become 1, right? That is next cost. So this will become 1. Now, after that, it will come out of this if, it will go to this for. And now for will execute for I is equal to 2. I will get incremented. Now I will become 2. This I will become 2. And again, control will jump over here. If A of C comma I, right? So C is what? C is right now 0. 02. A of 02 is what? 15, right? Is not equal to 0. This is correct. And visited of I, visited of 2 is exactly equal to 0. Let us check what is visited of 2. Visited of 2, this is also 0. So both the conditions are valid. That's why code will jump here. If A of C I is less than min, so C is 0 and I is 2. Let us see. C is 0 and I is 2. 0, 2. Right? This is less than min. What is the current value of min? Current value of min is 15 and A of C I 0, 2. This is also 15. So 15 is less than 15. This is not valid. So it will not execute this particular if. Right? So it will again come out of this if because this condition is not valid. A of CI is what? C is 0. Try to understand. C is 0 and I is 2. So A of 0, 2 is 15. This 15 should be less than min. What is the current value of min? Current value of min is 15. 15 is less than 15 is not valid. That's why this if will not execute. Control will come out and I will be incremented. Now I will become 3. I will become 3 now. Now for I is equal to 3, again it will execute. A of CI, A of 03. A of 03 is what? 20. Is not equal to 0. And visited of 3 is also not equal to 0. Now if A of C comma I is less than min, what is CI? 03. 03 is what? 20. 20 is less than 15. This is not valid. That's why this if will not execute. Right? Control will again come over here and I will be incremented. For I is equal to 4, this for loop will be broken. Right? Now, if min is not equal to 999, this will come to this one. So cost is equal to cost plus k min. Okay? What is the current value of cost? Cost is 0. Cost is equal to cost plus k min. What is the current value of k min? K min is 10. Right? So 0 plus 10 is what? So that is 10. So here, cost will become now 10. Now cost will become 10. Right? And it is going to return what? It is going to return NC. What is the current value of NC? NC is equal to 1. That means next cost or next node is 1. That means what we have done in this iteration, we have added the distance between 0 and 1. If you are observing in the result, we have added the distance between 0 and 1. Okay? So it will return NC. It will return it where? It will return to this function. Right? So least function has been called from where? Least function has been called from here. So it will return 1 to NCT. Right? So NCT value will become 1 now. That means next city value will become 1. Let us write this value over here. Let me write it properly. So here NCT will become 1. Next city will become 1. As you are getting in the output, first city is 0, next city is 1. So we are getting n city is equal to 1 here. Again, control will come over here. If city is not, if city is exactly equal to 999, right? If city is exactly equal to 999, n city is exactly equal to 999. What is the current value of n city? N city is 1. It is not 999. That's why this particular if statement will not execute. It will come out of this if and it will go over here and it will calculate min cost, n city, right? So this is a recursion if you are observing. Again, from here, control will jump over here. So it will call min cost of 1. So control will go from here to this city. The function is calling itself. So now city value will become 1. Go here. So city was initially 0. Now city value will become 1. City value will be changed to 1. This is the first iteration of this particular code. So city will become 1 now. And again, it will calculate this one. So int I and city, and visited of city will become 1. So visited of 1 will become 1 now. I hope you're getting. Now we are visiting 1, right? And from here, again, it will print this particular city. That means it is going to print this 1 if you're observing. It is printing this 1 in the output. And again, it will call what? It will call this list city. As we did operation in the list city, it will again call this list city. And next time, what it will return as NC, I'm intentionally not explaining the complete code, because here you can try this iteration as I have explained in the previous step. Here, now in NC, it is going to return this 3. Okay, so next city will become now 3. So NC will become now 3. Next iteration, NC will become 3. All the steps which I have explained in the previous explanation, they will get executed and NC will become 3, and next city will become 3. So here this will become 1, visited of 3 will become 1, right? Code will again come over here. NC will be 3. As NC is not 999, in that case it will call min cost of NC. So min cost of NC will be 3. So city will become now 3. Now city will become, next city will become 3, and again it will call the next iteration, and it will print what? Visited of city will become 1. Visited of 3, we have already made 1. Now it will call what? Printf city. So it will print 3 now. If you are observing here, 0, 1, and 3. And what will happen? Again, it will check nct is equal to 999. It is not valid. That's why it will call what? It will call min cost of nct. Again, iteration. Again, this will call as a recursion. So new value of city will become what? New value of city will become 3 now. So city has become 3 now. Right? And from here, it will calculate the least city, right? From here, it will calculate the least city. And next time, what will be the least city? Least city will become 2, right? And next to that, least city will become 0. When it will become 0, at that time, N city will become 999, and it will add all the cost, right? And when you are adding all the cost, you will get the total cost as 35. So this is the way how traveling salesperson problem with dynamic programming will execute. I have explained only one iteration of this particular code. Whenever this will get executed, it will call this put and it will print the cost. Okay, so remaining iterations you can understand by getting this code. I will share this code along with this particular video and you can identify accordingly. Thank you.